बैंक की भी दे दिया है। महाराष्ट्र, कर्नाटक, तमिलनाडु, आंध्र प्रदेश, लोन्स अगेंस्ट प्रॉपर्टी एंड गुड ग्रोथ कमर्शियल सक्सेस व्हाइल नर्चरिंग इट्स सोशल मीडिया।
It's a dream for all of us. I do realize that.
The Fincare Small Finance Bank is managed for its customers. The transformation to a bank in the year 2017, which is about 7-8 months ago, has only emboldened us to take this dual mission of commercial success and social impact even further with greater excitement.
Somewhere in between. My name is Pramod Kabra. I'm the chairman of the Fincare Small Finance Bank and also a partner in private 5% of economic stake of the Fincare Small Finance Bank. Our journey with the tumultuous period in that sense. We acquired two non-banking finance companies, namely Disha from Gujarat, only non-banking financial companies in those days, microfinance companies, who actually fully paid all the bank loans, paid unit leadership, and then came 2016 when Reserve Bank of India put a new policy of allowing the many of the non-banking finance companies to become small finance bank. Ours was one of the application that went in, and unique in some ways, who owned significant portion in the bank, but they were professional managers, all of them.
All parameters for them to have selected our institution as one of the 10 players to get small finance bank license. So really proud to be of this being part of the institution, and the fact that we have built a good platform for us to reach this point, and now we're looking forward to the journey in the future. So I'll just talk about a few data points that we are at today. As Pramod said, we were a non-bank till July 21st of last year, and from July 21st the bank was born. We changed our legal position on that day from a non-bank to a bank. So it was a conversion from a non-bank to a bank. We never started the institution from scratch. We were already running business. So we had what we call a starting position of loans out there, what we call assets. So it's a running organization. A lot of institutions start from scratch, but our organization was running from day one. So today, when we stand today, we are about 1800 crores of assets, the business that we already done in terms of loans. In a matter of 6 months, very proudly, I can state, we have been able to garner 600 crores of deposits across the country. We have a million customers. A lot of banks will not have these kind of customer base that we sort of are very proud of. And these are well spread out across the 7 states in the country. And as you can see on the right hand side, we are a bank which covers the west and the southern part of the country across Gujarat, MP, Maharashtra, Rajasthan, and coming south, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and Andhra Pradesh. So it's a very well diversified geography. The red dots actually denote the places that we have banking operations in, which are roughly today about 27 new bank branches that we have set up, what we call full service branches, and 260 existing offices of ours, which are called the microfinance offices, where we serve our rural microfinance customers. So overall, we have about 4,000 employees. Again, it's a large bank with a large employee base that is serving out our customers.
I've seen how technology makes a big difference in chess, and it has changed the world of chess, but it has also opened a lot of possibilities. We are able to take chess to a much wider audience, both in terms of distance and infrastructure. And I've seen how we are then able to share the benefits of chess with a much larger group. So when I met Fincare, I could see that they're trying to do in banking something very similar. On top of that, I felt that our values aligned, that we both prefer letting our achievements do the talking, our moves do the talking, as it were. And I like how they feel we can make a positive social impact by taking the benefits of banking to both the unbanked and the underbanked. You've seen, it's not just a question of technology, but also learning how to use technology in new ways to solve old problems, and you know, use innovative thinking. So we've seen both that they need a lot of employees to do doorstep service and interact with a lot of people. Probably there's a lot of convincing to do as well. But the benefits of financial inclusion will have a huge social impact. Again, for people who might just be starting out, it's very important, I think, that they have a they place a premium on customer protection, on making it easy. Again, very innovative use of methods, cash collection machines, allowing employees to get a lot of the procedures over with tabs, visiting people in their doorstep. And I think the importance placed on personal relationships. So it's fascinating for me to see that, to see these new methods being applied innovatively. And by Fincare Bank, which I think holds a lot of the values that I do very closely. So I'm very proud to join them in this journey, and I'm pretty sure that this will make a difference in people's lives, a positive difference in people's lives, and I hope to work together with them on that. Thank you so much.
Moving on to the second part of the agenda, and this is again in continuation to the theme of what has been moving into this physical world in some sense. So, you know, if that be the core theme of how our lives are getting a new milestone for ourselves, the start of a new journey for us, and this is what we want to do over the next 5-7 minutes, share with you a few slides which talk about what we are intending to do, all forms of social media which allow us to do the talking.
For small loans, that might be one of the things that a Fincare Bank offers that maybe is not so easy with a larger bank or a different mission bank. But let's say 101 would be a great way to start.
Very diversified. They start with overdraft lines. They start with funding of their equipment. They could be about working capital loans. You know, the MSME word is very loosely used. But fundamentally, there are some 7-8 products. They could be in need of vendor financing, bill discounting. Now, depending on the product, the process differs. Some are products with collateral, some are products without collaterals. Now, what we have done quite well over the last 6 months, 12 months is, even in the lending business, we've introduced digital solutions, and we are actually using tablets for sourcing, where we actually do customer underwriting using tablets. We instantly go and do an Aadhaar validation. We instantly go and do a CIBIL validation. And towards, 1 hour, 1.5 hours of the process, we're able to give an indicative proposal to the customer, on the loan that we can do. Because as I explained, small ticket business, and these 5 lakh, 10 lakh loans are again very small for the segment they're talking about. They need a very efficient process around it. And therefore, the efficiency, as you've seen, typically comes with using technology. A paper-based process makes them inefficient, and that's the very reason the big banks of the country are not able to service that segment, because the paper efficiency is not very good for that segment, and they also don't have papers to sort of hand over. So the processes differ, but we are using tablet-based sourcing to integrate some of the varied requirements, and depending upon the loan, we sort of ask a different set of questions, different set of information, and the loan gets serviced pretty much, or the loan gets sanctioned pretty much in a couple of hours after the interaction.